everybody. I'm Kevin Eschenfelder. Good to welcome you in. A lot of teams are playing college football on this Saturday, but you'd be hard-pressed to find two in the same stadium looking more forward to this game than Texas and Iowa State. Texas losing badly last week to Oklahoma, while Iowa State gave up 32 unanswered points in Lubbock against Texas Tech as they lost that one 52-21. And here to help me analyze this one today is former Texas Tech head coach Spike Dykes. Coach, you got a couple teams, I think maybe a bit of a make-or-break type of a game for these.
No question, Kevin. You know, the good thing about this game for both of those teams is it is, you know, it's a big-time conference game. There's still a lot of hope left, and I think odds are awful, awful good that it's going to be a tough contest. No question about that. This is make-or-break day for both teams.
Well, as far as Texas is concerned, Vincent Young's going to start a lot of football games over his career, but today is his first career start.
Yes, and I think it might be a this may be a magic day, because Vincent Young's got a great future ahead of him. This whole football team is looking forward to today. I think anytime you lose like both these teams did last week, they are, you know, they're hungry. They got to, Saturday finally got here, and they're ready to go, and I think we're going to see a heck of a football game.
Well, Iowa State has a couple of choices at quarterback, Chris Love, or you've got Austin Flynn, and you don't exactly know who's going to get the start here, but you got a couple of Texans that are going to be running the show for Iowa State.
Yeah, they're different kind of guys. You know, Austin Flynn, a great athlete, great high school baseball player, great high school track guy, as well as a football player from Deer Park, a freshman, and, boy, what a great player he is. And then Flynn is, you know, I mean, Love is a great guy. He's 6'5" guy, drop back passer, very maneuverable. You know, he's got a great future ahead of him. I don't think there's any doubt about the fact that this team has got two fine quarterbacks.
All right, the man that'll be roaming the sideline, and hopefully he's got out the SPF 40 on this day, because the sun is out today, talking about Chuck Reed. Chuck.
Kevin, you are right about one thing. It is a perfect day for football. Not a cloud in the sky, slight breeze from the west blowing across the field from the Texas sideline to the Iowa State sideline. A perfect day for Big 12 football. It's also a very big day for Iowa State coach Dan McCarney. Coach McCarney today will coach his 100th game at Iowa State, making him the coach who has coached the most games here at Iowa State ever. He breaks the record of 99 games held by Clay Stapleton, who coached here in Ames from 1958 to 1967. Dan coaching game 100 in his career in Ames, and he's hoping to make it a winning one against the Longhorns.
All right, thank you very much. The only way, yeah, it could be any more special than hitting the century mark would be hitting it on a day in which you pull off the upset victory over Texas. Iowa State to the Texas Longhorns from Ames when we come back. Ames, Iowa, just the fifth all-time meeting between Texas and Iowa State as the Iowa State Cyclones make their way out onto the field for homecoming 2003, the only other time Texas visited here. They were able to spoil the homecoming, a 44-41 victory, and that was on the last play of the game on an 18-yard field goal on that day by Chris Stockton. Texas coming into this one 4-2, ranked 20th in the nation after that loss last week to Oklahoma. They've had wins over New Mexico State, Rice, Tulane, K-State, and losses to Arkansas and Oklahoma for Mac Brown in his sixth season, 53-17. Fastest Texas coach in history to the 50-win plateau as Mac Brown bringing his team north to Ames, Iowa. And on the flip side, the man who, as we just heard from Chuck Reed, coaching his 100th game, doing something that no other Iowa State coach has ever done. Dan McCarney in his ninth season. Longest tenure in Iowa State history. To give you an idea, this is a man who's taken his teams to three straight bowl games. That, as well, unprecedented at Iowa State. Now, you'd be hard-pressed to get the weather any better. The temperature is expected to be in the mid-60s today, and not a cloud to be seen. And you can see a long way from up top of the stadium here in Ames, Iowa. Iowa State won the toss. They have deferred their decision to the second half, so Texas will have the football first. Right. Selvin Young goes back deep, along with Todd Miller. Selvin Young, I beg your pardon, and Terrell Brown back deep. So Yelk will kick it away. And we are underway here in Ames, Iowa. And Selvin Young from the goal line. Young out to the 15 and no more. A 14-yard return. Billups down on the coverage.
Great kickoff. That thing stayed in the air for a long time and allowed no run back.
So Texas starts it off first down at 10 from the 14-yard line as Vincent Young gets the start at quarterback. 6'5", 225-pound freshman from Houston Madison, the former high school All-American. He's the leading rusher on this team.
First snap's important, Kev, for a new quarterback, new starter. He got a chance to be up real tight. He just needs to get off to a good start.
He'll take it from the shotgun. Hand it to Cedric Benson. Huge hole for Benson. Out to the 30-yard line, a gain of 16 yards on first down as Cedric Benson and the guys up front just absolutely winning their battles. Mark Timmons, the free safety, had to make the stop. See the numbers on Vincent Young as he's completed 55% of his passes at 22 of 40 for 366 yards. Those are those big guys up front. Scott Holloway, Glenn Allen, and Blaylock opening that hole for Cedric Benson. He'll be flanked back there with Brock Edwards when they go with the two-back set. Roy Williams, B.J. Johnson, and Sloan Thomas are the wideouts.
Same play.
A 6-yard pickup this time for Cedric Benson, and these are the guys that will be trying to stop him. Johnson leaders, Karstens, keep an eye on him. Jordan Karstens is an outstanding player, but he has been hampered by injuries, along with Jason Berryman, the guys across the backers. Moser, Brown, Woodley, Cluess, and Hobbs are your corners, and Timmons and Jermaine Billups, maybe the real strong point of that secondary at safety. And there you see Karstens, academic All-American. Benson again. Haven't stopped him yet. Finally they do. It was Anderson that was there to make the stop. Eric Anderson, junior from Eden Prairie, Minnesota, holds Benson to a 2-yard gain.
Good backside pursuit on that play. And, you know, Cedric had another hole. I think he took the more drastic of the two cuts. Hey, the line's coming off good. They're off to a good, solid start. Will Allen's had a block every play that is outstanding.
That's third down and 3. Opening drive of the ball game for Texas. Iowa State showing blitz. Here they come. Young. Scrambling, got the corner, and got the first down. And that is what you will get from Vincent Young. Not only is he 6'5", 225 pounds, but he can absolutely fly. Picked up 5 on a 3rd down and 3.
That's why he's a special breed right there. That gives him a dimension that not many people have, and that's great athleticism and used to the teeth. First downs are the key. And, you know, when you can go do that and make a first down on a safety blitz, well, you got a chance.
Yeah, Cleophas Johnson had him right around the ankles, but that's not going to be enough to bring down Vincent Young. So they move the sticks, first down and 10, Texas, as the drive continues out to the 43-yard line. Again, fake the handoff, throw over the middle, caught by Williams. Williams at the 30, he could go, 20-yard line and out of bounds at the 12.
Great pass, right? Never broke a stride. Just a fantastic pass. Great crossing pattern by Williams.
A gain of 45 yards. Cluess finally was there to make the stop.
So that's what happens when you go run Cedric Benson 3 plays in a row. Now you fake it to him, and I tell you, that's great play action. Great call, and it's well executed.
Roy Williams, that was his 205th career reception. He's now at about 3,300 yards for his career. So first down and 10. Option play. Young. And they played it pretty well as Young goes out down about the 6-yard line. A gain of 5 yards. Joe Woodley was there to make the stop coming up from the weak linebacker spot. Senior from West Des Moines, Iowa.
Great job of stringing it out, I'll tell you that. That's the only way you got a chance against somebody like Vincent Young, because if you go overplay it, he's up inside gone. Second down and 6 on the 6-yard line.
Yeah, on the 7.
Please. 7-yard line. That is just where you want to be as far as offense is concerned.
You're going to have to get it right down to the 1-yard line for a first down. This is a good way to do it. In fact, touchdown, Texas. as Cedric Benson bobbed and weaved and took it in from 6 yards out. And what an impressive opening drive for the Texas Longhorns as they come out and take it 86 yards on the opening drive of the ball game.
What a block to Jonathan Scott on that play, a freshman that is really growing up and getting better every week. But that was a nice drive. You're right, Kevin. And that's what you need to do after you've had a bad game the week before, start out like that.
Big play on the drive, 46-yard completion, a hookup from Vincent Young to Roy Williams. Texas made it look real easy. Here's Dusty Magnum, had his 121 straight extra point streak in last week against Oklahoma, and he starts another one today. So just like that, didn't take long as Texas, a methodical drive, big plays, and a lot of brute force from Cedric Benson. They take a 6-0 lead. Coach, this drive was all about the guys up front winning their battles.
Well, that's Jonathan Scott. He gets two people right there, a good lead block by the fullback, and, you know, that's just a well-executed football play. You know, of course, the key to the whole deal was Will Matthews' block on the linebacker, but that is execution, and that's coming off the line of scrimmage, and that's a heck of a drive to start the game with.
Now, Cedric Benson, 30 yards rushing on that drive. Again, the big pass play was the 46-yard completion from Vincent Young to Roy Williams, took it down to the 12-yard line. A couple plays later, Texas was able to take care of business. A very impressive drive. 7 plays, 85 yards. Took 2 minutes and 42 seconds. And Cedric Benson carrying the mail on that one.
When you're playing a team like Iowa State on the foreign turf, and that first drive is so important, I'm telling you, because that takes the crowd out of the game a little bit.
Well, Lance Young back deep, along with David Banks Bursey, as they await the kick. Banks Bursey from 4 yards deep, and he will take a knee, and Iowa State will bring it out to the 20-yard line, where they start first down and 10. Iowa State, as you take a look at Chris Love, who comes into the game. Chris Love Jr. has completed 50% of his passes this year. Spent the last 2 years as a backup to Seneca Wallace. Take a look at the guys up front. Keep an eye on 75, Aaron Brandt, 6'7", 315-pound freshman. Backs and receivers, Wagner and Cook, Montgomery, Young, and Lane Danielson, one of the best receivers in the Big 12 Conference.
Love has got good range, 6'5", and drop back passes. That's his forte right there.
Throws it over the middle, and it's complete to Lane Danielson. Short gain of 3 for the senior from Dyke, Iowa.
Derek Johnson all over the field again to start with. A nice tackle for him to start with.
Now here's that defensive line. Crowder and right on the left side. Then you got Tubbs and Kalen Thornton on the right. Linebackers, Aaron Harris getting the start at the middle. Johnson, as you said, and Reed Boyd. Boyd's played all three positions. Basher and Cedric Griffin are your corners. Dakari Pearson cannot go today, so it'll be Philip Giger getting the start at the free safety. The strong safety is Michael Huff. Well, it's second down and 7 after that short game. They throw this one. Almost picked off. Boy, Nathan Basher had it roll up on the shoulder pads and just couldn't hold on. Jack Whitford couldn't hold on to it to begin with. Went through his hands, and then Basher wasn't exactly sure. I'm not sure if he knew the ball was going to get to him that quickly.
I think he thought the receiver was going to catch it because it went right through his hands. As you said, it was a juggling act, and a good piece of defense by Basher.
So third down, 6 to go for the first down. Love, time to throw it, does get this one away. He was being pressured from the start. Tim Crowder was right there in his face. And so it's punt time for Iowa State. Cyclones go 3 and out. Texas will get the football back.
This is really one of the keys to their football team. They got two great kickers, but Tony Yak is a great punter. And, he's in the running for the Kicker of the Year award and really has good numbers, good credentials. Kicks the ball a long way, kicks it high.
Basher goes back deep. You know, Yelp came to Iowa State as a kicker. Was not quite accurate enough, went over to punting. Now he's got the best career average in the history of the school. 43 yards this season and 43-yard average for his career. Bassett won't go in. Great coverage after a 50-yard punt and a zero-yard return. And you can look for Lane Danielson, because Danielson is as good as they get, not only from the wide receiver standpoint, but he'll be down on the tackles just about every time. All right, let's go down onto the field as we check in with Chuck Reed.
Kevin, I just checked over here on the Iowa State sidelines, and Jordan Karsten, far from 100%, the All-Big 12 defensive tackle for Iowa State, trying to gut it out today. He's got the injured knee. He played a little bit last week against Texas Tech, and again, just trying to gut it out today against Texas. They're not quite sure how long he can go, but he's going to give it his best shot. He's a tough kid. Look for him to stay in the ballgame.
Yeah, he's a very tough kid. Only four plays last week. This one goes nowhere. 33. Brandon Brown, the middle linebacker, stepped into the hole and did what a linebacker's supposed to do.
Great play. You know, one of the big things that's wrong with Iowa State, two things wrong. First of all, they played the hardest schedule in the country so far. Number two, they've had 17 guys miss a game because of an injury. And they just had the injury bug all year long. It makes a big difference.
Yeah, they spent the last three seasons going to bowl games, and they were just about virtually injury-free. Well, it's been kind of a payback time this year because they have had a ton of them. They throw this one. Almost picked off and should have been intercepted. It was Johnny Smith, the cornerback, who had that one go in and out of his hands. That would have been a huge break for Iowa State.
Well, we're on the wrong page here. Either the quarterback or the receiver, one made a mistake because he threw it right to where he thought somebody was going to be. There wasn't anybody there.
He hit him right in the chest. If anything, Johnny Smith let that ball get up on his body, bounce off his shoulder pads. So the crowd on its feet. Third down, 11. Looking for an Iowa State stop here. Young quarterback drop. Hit by Karsten, spins off. He'll be short of the first down out to the 31-yard line. A gain of 6. But the big guy we talk about, Jordan Karsten, is there to blow the play up from the start. And Mark Timmons was finally there to make the stop.
Watch Karsten. He's not at 100%. He is very, very, very tentative. You know, he's not full speed right now. I think Chuck was right. I don't believe he's got much time to play in this ball.
Yeah. Todd Miller goes back deep, waiting for the punt. The original speed, 41-yard average for the sophomore from Garland, Texas.
This is the best sniper in college football right now.
Came in a hurry there. Got to get it back in a hurry. He got there. Ball's loose.
Got a flag.
Penalty markers down. You're going to get interference, but it'll stay nonetheless with Iowa State as Miller had it, and they were right in his face. 35-yard punt. Well, the officials will sort this one out.
Get out of there, 45. Sort of nice to play football without the halo rule, right? The old halo rule was a pain in the rear, I'm telling you. And
just too much to determine, too much judgment there.
Oh, I promise you it is. No way to be consistent.
Kick catch interference on the kicking team. 15-yard penalty. First down, Iowa State.
Randy Crystal, our referee. It's Mac Brown encouraging the troops. It's a break for Iowa State as it moves it out to the 47-yard line.
Great field position. This is a good place to start when you're behind 7-0, I'll tell you that. So this will be an interesting drive for Iowa State and a big-time important one. Cyclones got to do something now. They're nearly in four-down territory, and they got to get back in this ball game. And now's the time to do it.
Take a look at those numbers. Pretty amazing what they've been able to do since the 2000 season began. Love, three-step drop, hit as he throws, gets it away, and it's complete for Lance Young. Young with first down yardage, a gain of 17, and they are in Texas territory. Cedric Griffin made the stop.
Perfect timing on this slant pattern. Watch this. Just absolutely perfect pass, perfect pattern, and that's hard to stop whatever defense you're in.
Nothing fancy about it. Just threw it out there before Johnson could cut across. First down and 10 from the 35-yard line. This time they roll the pocket. Pressure comes and Love goes down. came with the blitz, and it worked to perfection. Mike Williams off the edge, sophomore, getting some playing time and making the most of it. A loss of 8 on the sack.
Good blitz. This is big time blitz. And had a blocker on him, and he still gets in there, and that's good football.
Mike Williams from Lindale, Texas. He's a sophomore. So it's second down and 18. This one completing a flat, but that's it. Wow, speaking of flat, Nathan Basher knocked him flat.
Good defensive play. Good defensive play. They spread the field pretty good with their offense that time and throw the swing pass, and you know, they came up, and it's one of these deals where you make the tackle, you're in great shape, and it's one-on-one out there, and Basher did a great job.
Now Stevie Hicks loses 2. So it'll be third down and 20.
This is exactly the situation Iowa State didn't want in when they started on the 50, because this now this puts you behind the 8-ball.
Line to make for the first down is the 25-yard line from the 45. Love over the middle. Throws. This was complete. Danielson. Now they say it didn't happen. Looked like he got the arms underneath, but obviously it did not. Would have been short of a first down anyway.
Great pass. I'm telling you, Love is he's impressive. He stands up tall in the pocket. He's cool and delivered the ball right there. That was close to being a catch, I'm telling you. A lot of people in Ames thought it was a catch.
Tony Yelk will punt it. Nathan Basher goes back deep. Engling for the sideline, and he got it. Let's see where the linesman stops. Stops at the 5-yard line. So a 40-yard punt that goes out of bounds at the 5. That's good special teams. Texas up by 7. Couple of series with the gold on the outside. He's going with the reversible look. Now he's going back to the red. So, you know, get it. It didn't work with the gold, so you go to the cardinal and see if that works. Maybe trying to get this offense going. Man, it's a gorgeous day here.
I used to think fans were that way, Kevin. I used to think they came in one color, but they didn't do because they changed shirts. Yeah.
That wasn't what they were wearing. That was just their allegiance, Coach. Chance Mock comes in, and as promised, taking that third series, the junior from the Woodlands, Texas. Mock, straight drop and throw on the shotgun, and tipped away at the last second, played very well by the defense as Mark Timmons was out there. He also had help from Chris Whitaker, the middle linebacker, who almost got a hand on that ball.
Yeah, B.J. Johnson was covered pretty good on that play. They're mixing up some zone, some man, and when you get all those different looks, it takes a while to get it all figured out. It really does. You start out a game, you know what you're looking for, but those indicators are awful hard to determine sometimes, early in the game anyway.
Texas winning 13 of its last 14 on the road. Chance Mock. The throwback screen. And Selvin Young takes it out to the 15-yard line. A gain of 9 yards. Should be short of the first down. Leaders was there along with Jordan Karstens downfield to make the play. And Karstens, here's a guy that's got the problems with the legs, and he's still downfield making plays.
That's why he's all Big 12, Kevin. He's an outstanding defensive football player. Got a great pro future ahead of him. And he's playing hurt today. And, you know, that's what you got to do. I admire him. That's what leaders are all about, especially seniors like him.
Third down and less than a yard. That's going to be a legal motion. Justin Blaylock, the redshirt freshman from Plano, Texas. He went a little bit early. You go from third down and about a foot to third down at 5.
Quick trigger. Quick trigger will get you every time. Yeah, he's blocking on Karstens, and that really does make your trigger finger itchy. Believe me, it does. You want to get off on the snap, and it's hard to do. Changing personnel units now. We got the receiving corps coming in.
There you see Jordan Carstens. This is a young man from Bagley, Iowa. And they say he's not even really from Bagley because he's from, that's the closest town to where he's from. He's a farm kid. And during the harvest time, he will go back every Sunday to work on the farm. He's an academic All-American and seems only natural, an agricultural business major. Third down, 5 for Texas. Mock being pressured and goes down. Britt Gervais. A loss of 4, and it's plenty time for Texas.
This is really, really good pressure, and everybody's covered. Good defensive stand by Iowa State. Kevin, watch this snapper. Watch Cullen Loeffler. He is the best deep snapper in college football today. And I tell you, this is a rarity to snap the ball like he can. There's no telling what his value of this football team is or any football team.
Todd Miller awaiting the punt from Richmond McGee. Should be good field position for Iowa State. Miller makes the catch and goes down immediately. 36-yard punt. But Iowa State for the second straight series with outstanding field position. They'll start this drive inside Texas territory when we come back. Need to give that young lady something to cheer about. Good field position. Here's everybody taking in the beautiful weather here in Ames, Iowa. It's seasonably warm. Man will be hot under the collar if his offense can't get something going here, though.
You know, the key to this field position is the great punting by Yak. He has done such a good job. The coverage has been good and backed up Texas in a hole after that first drive, and they've had a hard time getting out of it. Of course, the elements today are near perfect. I don't think anybody can ask for a better day to play football. My gosh, it's crisp, it's cool, and great venue here, great crowd. And Iowa State's done so much with their facilities, it's not even funny since the last time I was here. And it is really phenomenal what they've done.
Well, coming up at halftime, we'll talk with Athletic Director Bruce Vandeveld about some of those things and the way things have really changed for the better here at Iowa State. Really progressed. Love goes down. Goes down at the 49-yard line, a loss of 6.
Looked like he turned his ankle just a little bit. Awkward slip. Texas is playing man free. They got a man on everybody, and then they have a free safety in the middle trying to play center field. And to do that, you've got to get great pressure on the quarterback. That allows you to rush 5 people, though. And so with a 5-man rush, you ought to be better than you are with a 4-man rush. This is a little too deep here. Zone.
Love again, 3-step drop going up top. Well, the receiver came back. It was Lance Young, and he ran a little comeback pattern, and Love obviously thought he was headed the other way.
Kevin, that's a great example of changing coverages. The play before, they were in tight man-to-man with a free safety. This last play, they were in two deep zone, and they had 2 free safeties, and so it's altogether a different concept. And the quarterback that does not have tremendous starting experience, as Love does, it's hard to read. And you play them all together different as far as pattern recognition.
Iowa State trying to convert on their first third down of the day. 0 for 2 so far. Long goes down. Back at the 45-yard line, the pressure continued to come. And finally, it broke down. Another loss of 6. And for the third straight time, it is 3 and out for Iowa State.
That was great pressure by the front 4. And that was a 4-man rush. And boy, did they ever play it good.
Marcus Tubbs and Tim Crowder team up to get the sack. Crowder, a true freshman.
Unbelievable for a true freshman to be as good as he is. Here's the best player on Iowa State's team so far, in my opinion, in this game, is their punter.
Tony Elk. Yup. Right there, tough pressure. He gets this one away. This one, though, goes into the end zone. It is a 53-yard punt, but only a 33-yard net as Texas will have the football out at the 20-yard line.
That hit like my 9-iron, Kevin. Instead of batting, it rolled. If it had bit, it'd been right there on the 2-yard line. Great punt. Bad luck.
So Vincent Young will come back in at quarterback this time after Chance Mock had that third series. Cedric Young, a single setback. First down and 10 from the 20. Texas with a 7-0 lead. Took the opening drive of the ball game, 85 yards. And that is where we stand right now. 7-0 as Cedric Benson went in for 6 yards out. Benson trying to get to the corner. Has a gain of maybe a couple, about as well as you could play the option. Brandon Brown was there to escort him out of bounds.
Excellent lateral pursuit out of Iowa State. The Cyclones, they've got a lot of speed to linebacker in the secondary. And it's obvious when you run wide because they can get a lot of people there.
They picked up 3, second down and 7. Counted down to 4 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Cedric Benson this season, 358 yards rushing, averaging about 4 per carry and 7 touchdowns on the ground.
That's exactly right. The touchdowns and that statistic were the number one impressive thing about Cedric Benson.
Handed to Benson on the delay, breaks through. Benson out to the 33-yard line, a gain of 11 yards before Mark Timmons was there to make the stop. Remember, Benson, last time these two teams met, he went for 199 yards rushing and 2 touchdowns. That was last year in Austin against Iowa State.
What's the left side of the line again? The left side is wearing them out. That's the side they've run to nearly all of their good runs, and they know something. I think probably the reason is Castrens is playing on their right side.
Run away from the big man.
The big man is a good player. He's on the other side.
Benson Young, straight drop throw. Hit as he throws. It's still complete. B.J. Johnson came back and got the ball and picks up 11. Jason Berryman was the man who was hanging all over Vincent Young.
Mark of a good receiver right there, Kev. He did a nice job of coming back to the football. And, you know, this is a bad example of what a lot of young receivers don't do, is they don't come back to the football, makes the quarterback look bad. That was an excellent play. Heads up.
Just the 10th catch of the season for B.J. Johnson. You know they want to get him more involved, and they did right there.
But he's a good one.
Benson on the option. Midfield hit there and blasted out of bounds after a gain of 6. Ellis Hobbs meets Cedric Benson.
You know, this is a great execution by Vincent Young. Look at him. He's standing down in the line of scrimmage, pitches out left-handed, makes the end taking, makes him bite on him, and not a great play, just 6 yards. You know, 6 yards and 6 yards and 6 yards adds up to lots of points and a lot of first downs. That's a great play. Good play. Good blocking by the left side of the line again.
Ball right at midfield. Second down and 4. Play action. Young. And the time to roll. Throws this one and it's complete, but a short gain is knocked out of bounds at the 42-yard line. A gain of 6 is David Thomas, sophomore tight end.
First down, though. Vincent Young was aware of where the first down marker was, and he saw David. And David's a great young receiver. I think he's got success written all over him, and he's got great maneuverability and knows how to get open. Good play. Keeps the drive going. First and 10.
Got just enough for the first down. Move the sticks. Take a look at that. Total yards. Iowa State hasn't moved it an inch. This is also the 19th play that Texas has run. Iowa State's run just 10. Young again. You can check his watch back there. Gross, and it's incomplete. Boy, he had tons of time. Johnny Smith had the coverage on B.J. Johnson.
Plus, he had a pretty good avenue right back up the middle. Look at that middle open up. I was thinking he was going to tuck it and run because he had 15 or 20 yards. Look at all that daylight in there. But good pass. I tell you, he gave the receiver a chance. The receiver just didn't see the football. Great protection then. You know, you can't have too much time to throw the ball. And when you have too much time to throw the ball, everything's out of sync, and it makes it tough.
If there was ever an example of having too much time, that may have been it, because he was all by himself back there. Young, little misdirection handoff, and it's not going to work. Cedric Benson ran right into Jason Berryman, Berryman, a true freshman. He's from Houston Cashmere High School. A 6-yard loss for Benson.
As a blitz coming, they ran it right, ran the handoff right into the blitz, and you know, great call by the defense. And you're talking about smelling it out. They did it. They did a good job of calling the right defense against the right play. And too many bodies to block. What's this?
Down.
They got one too many, and they can't do anything about it. And got all this heat coming from the side that they're trying to run to, and everybody else slanting away. So just one of those bad calls.
Now Texas is facing a 3rd down and 16. Longhorns 1 of 3 on the afternoon at 3rd down efficiency. Here's Young. Pressure coming over the corner, and they blow the play dead. Jermaine Billups was coming in a hurry on the safety blitz.
Prior to the snap,
we've
ball
got
start.
A two-way player out
offense.
There.
Kenny,
who is also he's normally one of their tight ends, is now playing defense. And, you know, that's what you got to do when you have 17 injuries. You got to move people around. You got to play them in different positions. And, you know, that's what happens when, you, when you've only got 85 guys on scholarship.
That's Tim Toprink. And, you know, he's played tight end. He played tight end last week against Texas Tech.
Yeah, he's just a guy that's willing to play anywhere, anytime. They look confused right now. They're not for sure.
Iowa State rushes 3. Young throws, intercepted. Joe Woodley. And Woodley back to the 40, to the 38-yard line. He runs it back 22 yards, and Iowa State's got something going. Well, Woodley's a former fullback. His father's a head coach at Pasadena High School in the Houston area. And he looked like he knew what he was doing with the football there.
Yeah, that's a great interception. And, you know, to begin with, they have great pressure. They brought the corner blitz again. And Woodley just makes a tremendous football play. Got his eyes on the quarterback. Vincent did not look him off, obviously, quite long enough. And he came in and made the play. What a great turnaround.
That's back-to-back weeks. He had his first career interception last week against Texas Tech. Picks off his second in as many weeks. Throw the quick slant. This one complete. Lane Danielson picks up 13 yards. Chris, Michael Huff was there to ride him down.
Chris Love grows up every play. He looks like he's getting better. He's getting his confidence. He's getting in rhythm. And, Kevin, this is a great pass. I mean, there's not much of a window there. He's covered good, and nice pass, nice catch.
So down to the 24.
Danielson, as you said earlier in this broadcast, is one of the best receivers in the Big 12, and that's the reason why right there.
Wagner, his first carry of the game. Wagner to the 10, to the 9-yard line. Michael Wagner, the senior from West Covina, California, making the most of his first carry of the game. A gain of 16 yards. Phillip Giger for Texas saved the touchdown.
Quick as a hiccup, isn't he? That was a nice hole and a good job blocking by the left side of the line. And watch how quick he is. And now that spread formation, you know, I guess now you're a communist if you don't run the spread formation. Everybody every week runs the spread. And that's the reason why, I guess.
First and goal. Go to Wagner again. Wagner hit in the hole. But Tim Crowder stepped in and filled the space in a hurry.
Good play by Crowder. Excellent play. Good one-on-one tackle in a tough area.
Well, Wagner, the young man, really had to come in and fill some big shoes when he replaced Hiawatha Rutland, who went out early in the season. He's had some big games. Went for 115 against Ohio, 97 against Northern Illinois, and 87 against Northern Iowa. Right now, though, he'll head to the other side, hoping to get into the end zone and tie this game. Into the first quarter, 7-0 Texas.
Back to Jack Trice Stadium. We're visiting with Jim Oliver, who is the director of the Virtual Reality Application Center here at Iowa State University. What exactly is the Virtual Reality Application Center?
First of all, it's a mouthful. We usually refer to it as VRAC. VRAC is a multidisciplinary research center that serves all of Iowa State University. VRAC is about 30 faculty and 150 students doing research on a variety of projects with a value of over $10 million. It's also the home of the C6, the first fully immersive six-sided virtual environment. C6 is like visiting a holodeck on Star Trek.
All right, let's go back to the action. Hang on 1 second, Jim. We'll come back to you.
All right, first play of the second quarter. It'll be a second down and goal to go from the 7-yard line.
Big series for the Cyclones right here now. This is make or break time, Kev.
Well, they got to get something. They had way too good a field position. And you got to come away with points here. Iowa State trailing 7-0. It'll come back and it's knocked away. Marcus Tubbs as we head back to Chuck.
Oh, what a great
Jim, can you tell us a little bit about the research you're doing?
Sure. Our professors and students work on use virtual reality and a variety of interface technologies to work on a wide variety of things. For example, imagine standing in a 50-foot-tall industrial furnace and watching otherwise invisible gases flow around you to try and improve energy efficiency. Or imagine visiting a Hindu temple that, as it existed 500 years ago, and experiencing an ancient ritual. Or.
Thanks, Jim.
All right, third down and goal. They throw this one, and it's going to be short of the first down, obviously of the touchdown, but Lane Danielson can't make the catch anyway. Michael Huff was there for the coverage. So now it is field goal time for Iowa State.
That was a nice drive. That was – they took advantage of a turnover, and that's what you got to do.
A 24-yard field goal attempt. Adam Beneke to put the Iowa State Cyclones on the board, and it's blocked. So another golden opportunity missed for Iowa State.
Great penetration by the defense right there. I really think that's one play in football, Kevin, that's underemphasized is the field goal and extra point block. It takes. Because you go try it 100 times, you don't get one, and then here comes Derek Johnson
got it.
Derek Johnson right on the button, and great players make great plays. That's what makes them great players, and another good play by Derek Johnson.
Ball comes out to the 20-yard line.
That's important for two reasons. That crowd is quiet, and Texas has still got a commanding 7-0 lead.
And the football, Vincent Young has it. Starting for the shotgun at the 20-yard line. Young, quarterback draw. Tried to cut it back to the near side. Still picks up a gain of 3 yards before Jermaine Phillips was there to make the stop.
Good defensive play. There was a better hole than that, and defense reacted well. I'll tell you one thing about Dan McCormick's football teams. I've never played against anybody or coached against anybody that their team played any harder for 60 minutes every Saturday. And Dan has done a great job with that. And this is obvious as they're playing right now.
Option play. Cedric Benson knocked out of bounds at the 26-yard line. You know, you go back to that field goal attempt. And I think it may have been Marcus Tubbs with the push right up the middle. Watch Marcus Tubbs right there in the middle come through. Yeah, it was 95 Tubbs that got that.
Well,
or was it Johnson?
It still looks like Johnson. Johnson or Tubbs, I'd say. But what a great push by both of them. Tubbs is doing everything else. I imagine he blocked that field goal.
Well, it's third down and four. Texas just 1 of 4. And the field goal in the third down efficiency department.
Good job of running there. Yep. Nice little cutback.
Cephas Johnson made the tackle. A gain of 5, though, and a first down. As that'll silence the crowd for a while.
I tell you, the defense on both teams is doing a nice job of disguising. They're not playing the same 1-2 plays in a row, and that really makes it hard on quarterbacks, and neither one of these quarterbacks have a lot of game experience, and so it makes it difficult.
Johnson has it at the 35. and Johnson run down at the 12-yard line, a gain of 55 yards. Johnny Smith finally there to make the tackle, but how about Roy Williams throwing the ball, going up top and going deep to his partner, B.J. Johnson.
That's a good play. That slows down that aggressive defense. But watch Roy Williams fling that ball. And B.J. makes a great catch, but of course Roy's a great athlete. But what a heck of a play.
And a big gainer, and Texas is in great shape after Iowa State couldn't take advantage of great field position, couldn't put points on the board. Texas is knocking at the door again.
I'll tell you, Johnny Smith can run now. He caught B.J., and I didn't think there was any way to catch him when he started.
Benson hit at the line of scrimmage. You're going to get a holding penalty against Texas. William Winston is going to get called for the hold. Big number 78 was holding Cephas Johnson, number 43.
That's what you call a slobber knocker right there now, Kevin. I mean, that is a great hit. And right in the snout. And, you know, that's the kind of things that Iowa State's always done under Dan McCartney. They played great aggressive defense, and that was a great example of it.
Holding. Offense. It'll be a 10-yard penalty. Replay first down.
There it is, right on the right of your screen, right in the middle of your screen. That is the definition of a hold.
That's a hold, and that's an example of a guy making a great play after it was held.
Here's Vincent Young trying to find an opening. Young with room to run. At the 10, and then run out of bounds at the 8-yard line. He's still there to pick up 14 yards on first down and 20.
He looks like he's strolling through the park. He makes all that hard stuff look so easy that it's not even funny. What a great fluid action he's got. And you know the thing about him, Kevin, he runs fast and he looks like he's just barely moving because he is so well coordinated.
Eric Anderson, 58, still looking for him. They may have to replace his shoestrings.
I'm telling you, he's got that. Those loose hips.
Second down and 5 from the 8-yard line.
Big play right here.
Benson will walk into the end zone. An 8-yard touchdown stroll, as you said.
Well, the left side, I'll tell you, watch it when they show the replay on this. Watch Jason Glenn, the center. Jason Glenn, the center, just makes this all work. It's just it's what you call blocking. And I'm telling you what, it's beautiful. Just a well-executed football play and a great job of the offensive line. Hey, this line is young. This line is getting better every single solitary Saturday, and I think they're proving it today against a good defensive football team. And especially a good defensive team against the run.
And the point after is perfect. So the offensive line dominating for Texas is opening a huge hole. So Cedric Vincent can do just that, give Texas a 14-0 lead. Top of drives. Well, when they are on, and they lead it by a score of 14-0 right now. Now, they've had some drives when they didn't look good. Iowa State, though, they should be on the board as well. They have not been able to take advantage of the opportunities that have been given them. Well, David Banks, Bursey back deep along with Lance Young. Banks, Bursey, 3 yard deep. He won't bring it out. It'll bring out to the 20-yard line.
Yeah, you got to be careful right there, Kev. We had a guy do that one time, knelt down, stepped on that line with his toe.
Not supposed to do that. They tend to frown on that.
They tend to frown on it. That's a bad day at Black Rock when that happens.
Well, a gorgeous day here in Ames today, that's for sure. Temperatures going to reach the mid-60s today. A day with a beautiful blue sky, no clouds. But Iowa State trying to get its offense going right now. That's what they're worried about. First Love throws this one complete. Finds his man, Lance Young, who makes his first catch of the day, 17th catch of the season. His 4-yard pickup, short gain.
Another play by Vasher. I mean, that's making one of those plays that
people take for granted, but when you miss it, it's a big play, and a nice job of Vassar.
Brings it out to the 24-yard line. Second down and six.
Mike Williams did a good job rushing the passer on that play. He had the tackle back in the quarterback's face, and hey, Steve Brickett, the offensive coordinator, has given them about every set I've seen in football since.
Three wide here and handed off to Michael Wagner. And Wagner back to the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a couple. Derek Johnson was there to knock him off his pins.
I think Derek Johnson is one of the best college football players in America, hands down, without a doubt. He play after play after play, and he's a sure tackler, and he's all over the field. I tell you, he's got instinctive, and what a great player. What a great explosion he's got.
Big, fast, and nasty, and that is a very good combination if you're a defensive coach.
Sound like some of my old girlfriends.
First team all-conference player. Look out, here they come from the backside, and Love goes down. Well, they were coming in an awfully big hurry, and it was Michael Griffin coming from that corner blitz there to make the play.
That's a freshman right there now, yep. And a freshman playing awful well at this stage of his game.
Yeah, Love didn't stand a chance.
Good call by Carl Reese. The the defense has been variable all day long. They've not done the same thing twice in a row, and it's given Chris Love a hard time.
So Yelk will punt it. Vassar back deep to run it back. Peter. This one off the side of his foot really shanked this one. A very rare sight for Tony Yelk to miss one this badly. A 44-yard punt, make it a 28-yard punt out to the 44-yard line.
We bragged too quick, Kevin. That's what happens when you brag on somebody. You know, I was bragging on that pitcher the other night, and then baseball game, the next play they had a home run, a knuckleballer. So you can't brag too quick.
All right, Chance Mock comes back in to run the show for the Texas Longhorns. Another former high school All-American. He had a hard time getting the offense jump-started today.
This is a little better field than he had last time, too. This gives him a chance. He was on the 5-yard line last time. That's hard.
Mock, plenty of time to throw, spins out. And off the hands of the tight end, David Thomas.
B.J. Johnson, if he'd seen B.J. down there, I want you to look at B.J. if you see this again. You talking about wide open. Of course, he's under duress, and it's hard to see those guys. But wasn't anybody in 15 yards.
Jason Berryman and Nick Leaders were chasing Chance Mock all around the yard.
Chance did a good job of getting out of that sack. He had a great little spin move.
So second down to 10, Dan McCarney trying to get his defense fired up here. Defense has played pretty well. It's been the two drives. That's all Texas has been able to put together. Mock changing the play of the line of scrimmage. Here comes the blitz. Billups has him, lost him. Mock throws downfield, complete. B.J. Johnson and, boy, Jermaine Billups should have had him wrapped up for a loss of five. Instead, it's a gain of 22 yards.
That's a great football play. It's great strength. Chance is a strong son of a gun, and let me tell you something. And then he regains his coolness and throws it to B.J. That's where B.J. was on the last play. Same situation. He found him this time. Good pass on the dead run.
And he still threw that, and Billups was hanging on him when he threw it.
Yeah, he's strong. He's a good quarterback.
The ball at the 22-yard line. First down at 10. 10 minutes to go here in the first half. Protection is there for Mock this time. Throws it out in the flat. Complete. Bo Scaife and Scaife inside the 10 down to the 7-yard line.
Good read. That's a good read. Hard read. They're playing man-to-man under and Bo just kept on maneuvering to get open and did a nice job getting open. And Chance did a good job of finding it. Good pass. Bo's a load. That's hard tackle for those little cornerbacks, I'm telling you.
Guy that missed last season with an injury. Back, and he is an outstanding tight end. Senior from Denver, Colorado. That's his ninth catch of the year. That one goes for 15 yards, and it's first down and goal. Selvin Young to the 5-yard line. He stood up there, a couple of yards on that game. Texas leading the all-time series between these two teams, 4-0. It's only the second time that they've ever played here. Last time they were here, they won it on a last-second field goal by Chris Stockton. Only the second time in Texas history that Texas had won a game on the last play of the game.
21-10 last year, wasn't it? And in the last game.
At Austin. And
So they won the last two by 14 points. That's playing it pretty close to the vest.
Yeah, they've won the season series, or the series all time. They've won by an average of 10 points. So not exactly been blowouts one way or the other. Brandon Brown was there to make the tackle on Selvin Young, and Young just picks up a couple. And it'll be third down and goal for Texas.
This is a good defensive play. Carstens is really a good football player. He draws two blocks. He makes things happen. And when you got a double team, one guy gives everybody else a great opportunity.
Well, Young goes out, and Benson comes back in. He and Will Matthews the fullback. Timing pattern for Williams, couldn't hold on, a little bit too tall.
That's a good call. That was a tall guy against a short guy, just a little bit of a miscue on the throw. But,
yeah, that's a good point right there. Ellis Hobbs, one cornerback, he's only 5'7", 185, and that was Hobbs in coverage against Roy Williams at 6'4", 220.
A tall 6'4".
Yeah. A 20-yard field goal attempt.
Watch this snap. I'm always impressed with Cullen Locker. I tell you, he's amazing.
Dusty Mangum. From 20 yards out, gives Texas a 17-0 lead with 7 minutes, 58 seconds to go in the first half. We'll take a break. Come back to Ames, Iowa in just a moment. Near sellout crowd here today at Jack Trice Stadium. And they've not had a whole lot to cheer about, at least those from here in Iowa. 17-0. That's the way to take in a football game. Up on the hill, bring your blanket, pack a lunch. It's a good day for that.
I tell you, this venue is outstanding. The stadium is, they've really done a nice job adding on this stadium, and the press box is nice. The whole ball of wax is first class.
A beautiful day for homecoming. Couldn't be any better. The exception, I guess, the offense to get rolling a little bit. That would be the, you see that railing to the right, that is behind the stadium here, and that's a new football complex, indoor football complex for their practice facility. Should be finished as early as November, and that's without all the bells and whistles. It'll be completely finished coming up in February. But they've got a lot of exciting things going on here on campus at Iowa State. The Texas with three scoring drives of less than 3 minutes. When the offense has clicked, the offense has clicked.
And the defense has responded with the Cyclones have 28 yards, is that right?
Yeah, those 28 yards didn't come until the last drive. Last time they had the football was the only time they'd moved it. They were in the second quarter and did not have a yard of total offense. They'll try to get it rolling here once again.
I think the big deal is that Iowa State has had nothing on first down. It's always second and 10, second 11, second 12. You can't play a defense like Texas unless you have a four or five yard gainer on first down.
Well, Stevie Hicks comes in at the tailback. Again, four wide receiver set. Going up top. Banks Bursey, and David Banks Bursey can't catch up with that one. The coverage was there, though, from Nathan Bashers. He was there step for step with the senior from New Boston, Texas. Now, you'll see a Lone Star influence on this Iowa State team. You know, as we talked about, Austin Flynn and Chris Love, who you see right there, both Texans. Love from Round Rock, Texas, in the Austin area, right up the street from the University of Texas. But the fact they have 18 Texans on their roster. This time they throw the ball. Masher was closer to it than the receiver. He had great inside position. Really never let the receiver, Jack Whitford, get inside of him.
See, that's the same play, Kevin, a while ago that they completed against Vasher, and Vasher said, not twice. Not going to let the same dog bite me twice. So he overplayed the inside route, overplayed the slant, and I'd look for now for a slant up pretty quick.
Now, the key to that number is right there is the fact that he has been sacked four times in this game. So it's third down and 10. Got to get it to the 30 if you want to move the chains and keep the ball. The timeout is called by Chris Love. Iowa State wants to talk this one over. So a timeout on the field. Big play coming up for the Cyclones. They face a third down and 10, trailing by 17. They'll do it when we come back to Ames, Iowa, just a moment. That's been all Texas so far, 17-0, as Iowa State faces a big third down of 10 here. Got to get some semblance of offense going here in this first half. Mack Brown's defense has been up to the task so far, that is for sure.
I would imagine that we might see Austin Flynn pretty soon if they don't start moving it.
Chris Love, young man in there right now, just take a look at DJ Johnson. And Chris Love, junior from Round Rock, spent the last couple of seasons backing up Seneca Wallace, has had a couple of chances and made the most of his opportunities, but today the offense has struggled mightily.
The front four of Texas has played extra good. They really have come on and brought the heat.
They try to bring the heat here. This time protection is there, throws it over the middle, and great job by Giger, as Giger was there to knock the ball away from Lance Young.
Great break.
Yep, Phillip Giger making the start here for Degari Pearson. He's able to separate man from football.
Giger is a big play guy. He's made a lot of big plays this year in the limited amount of time he's played, and I think he's an excellent player.
So Tony Yelk. A busy man today. We'll punt it again. He had a really missed one the last time out, but still he's averaging 43 yards per punt. That's his season average. That's his career average, and that's what he's averaging today. Here comes Texas. They almost got there. Low liner. And Vasher with room to run. Vasher out to the 47-yard line. Only a 5-yard return, and Coach, all things considered, as low a punt as that was, and as good as the pressure was, plus, they did a nice job covering that.
Plus, we got a clip. I believe we got a clip, and looked to me like, and if that is, well, then the punt was really a good one. Because you had 15.
Block in the back during the return. 10-yard penalty. First down, Texas.
Push in the back.
Push 10 yards, right?
Yep, bag it back 10 more yards.
You know, it used to be simple. There used to be two penalties, 5 yards and 15 yards.
Yeah, you don't clip anybody anymore.
Oh, no. They got 78 definitions.
Yeah, you get.
And some of them are 10 yards, some of them are 15. It just depends on the official.
The illegal use of hands, pushing back. Here's something young. Getting away from a couple of defenders. Hurdles the 45-yard line out to the 47. A gain of 8 yards before Whitaker and Berryman are there to team up to make the stop.
He's amazing. Now that guy has got some—he's got some juice, doesn't he? He can dance, and I tell you, he is smooth as silk, and he has got great peripheral vision.
Cut it back up. Young man went to high school in Houston, Houston-Madison High School, where he was a parade All-American in the high school ranks. Cedric Benson dancing his way for a gain of 5. Eric Anderson makes the stop, but not before Benson gets inside Iowa State territory, the 49-yard line.
That left side still doing good. I'm telling you, those guys are playing good. They got the number two guys. Terrence Young's left guard right now. They got Tweedy in there at left tackle, and you know, the center is, center's still Jackson Glenn, but.
Play action, throws this one in the flat, complete. And Roy Williams will go down immediately. That is extremely well played by Mark Timmons, because Timmons was holding on to a very big wide receiver. Big and strong. And he knows what to do when he has the football.
That's one of those plays that's designed to break a tackle. If you break a tackle, it's a 25-yard gain. He just made a great tackle, as you said. I mean, that is a great open field tackle.
Jason Berryman was coming 100 miles an hour to it. They'll show you right there. The veteran senior, as Roy Williams knew that he had had enough and it was time to get down. There was no reason to have to look at what Jason Berryman was bringing. Here's Cedric Benson. Literally hurdled the blocker there and the defender as he got it out for a gain of a couple more out to the 39-yard line.
That's a great example there of the offensive line coming off. And I'm talking about drive blocking, and they ran a zone play, and it just moved the defensive line back. And that's a great credit to the offensive line right there. They've done a good job today. They picked up a number of blitzes, and they played a good game.
Well, it's third down and two. Iowa State defense looking to come up with a big play here. Benson. If he got it, he just did. Whitaker was there. The flag is down. Timmons was also in there on the stop. Also, Joe Woodley was maybe the first man to get to him. He needed two. Looks like he got three, but check the penalty marker.
Offside.
You always see
defense,
that on
the 5-yard penalty. Sufficient.
Third
for a first
or fourth down.
Down
is short. You'll see that all the time.
I could have called that play, Kevin. You know how I could have called it? Because Carson was playing on the offensive right, left side that time, so they're going to, I mean the right side, they're going to run
left.
To the left. He is a good player, and I can't say enough about him, and got great up and down the line speed to weigh 300 pounds. He'll be in the NFL one of these days. He won't have to, he can send somebody back to do the farmer.
Do the farming work for
uh-huh. Yeah, yeah. He plays all out. He's quite a guy.
Well, if he's not in the NFL, that captain right there, he won't have any problems. Like I said, he's an academic All-American. Agriculture and business major. Young. Tons of time. Now it breaks down. Still Young. Looks like he went absolutely nowhere. Picks up 8.5 yards before Joe Woodley can finally get there and knock him out of bounds.
Just watch this play. And this is what we're talking about the whole time. Watch Carson's number 92. He's battling. He's fighting. He's scratching. He's digging. He goes the whole way, never quits, and I'm telling you, and he's playing on about a leg and a half, and he doesn't have any give up to him. I'll tell you that about him. Those are the kind of guys that you admire and you love to coach, because they lay it on the line for you every time.
Benson hit immediately and goes down. Nick Leaders.
Good gosh, that's a good play.
Well, Leaders got there in a hurry. He and his brother Andy on this team. They're sons of the late Mike Leaders, who was an all-conference linebacker here back in 1979. A 2-yard loss.
Big play right here. Big play for the Cyclones. 17-0 is not near as bad as 24-0. They got to make a stand right here.
Third down, 4. They hand it to Benson, and he's not going to get there. Defended very well. Jermaine Billups was the first man that got there. It was just a gain of a couple, so a fourth down is coming up. And Texas is going to call a timeout. You're at that point right now. You're at... They wanted to spot the ball and see exactly how much he was going to have. It's going to be fourth down and about 3. Now, Iowa State, as you said, one of the toughest schedules you're ever going to find in college football this year, and that was exactly the case this season. And they've got been a tough road to hoe. They started with wins against Northern Iowa and Ohio and lost to Iowa at Northern Illinois, lost to Oklahoma, and last week to Texas Tech. Next week now, they take on Nebraska, trying to do something they haven't done since the early 70s, and that is win back-to-back games over the Nebraska Cornhuskers.
Kevin, that's 5 ranked teams in a row, and, you know, next week will be 6. That's... That says a lot. And, you know, I think this is two great coaches that are in this game today. I think Dan McCartney's done the most magnificent job anybody could ever believe at Iowa State. And Bennett Hunter's game is unbelievable. And I think Mac's done a great job. He's got Texas back in the top 10 the last 2 years, contending for national titles. And, you know, two great programs and two great coaches. And it's quite obvious that the teams are able to play good.
Tough stretch for Iowa State. Not only do you have Texas today, Nebraska next week, and then K-State back to back to back. It's get a whole lot easier with Colorado. And then at Kansas, who has been a much improved football team, and then at Missouri. So fourth down and three. Young throws it in the flat, complete to Benson. Has the first down to the 25-yard line. A gain of four on fourth and three. Jermaine Phillips made the stop, but not before he was able to pick up the first down.
That's the best cut I've seen Benson make. Watch Benson avoid the tackle, and this is really a great cut. Good pass, good catch, but watch the cut he makes. Ooh, right there, that gives him the first down. Cedric Benson is... you know, has not been quite as flashy as he's been the last couple of years. It's good to see him make a cut like that.
From the 25-yard line. Option play. Benson to the 20. Looking fancy right now. He's picking up 4 or 5 yards at a time. Jermaine Phillips and Ellis Hobbs there to make the tackle. Again, a 5-yard pickup, and they're trying to put more points on the board before we get to halftime. 2.5 minutes to play in the first half.
Well, this is another one of the deals we talked about a while ago, Kevin. First down, they're making 5 yards. It's pretty easy to make 5 yards the next three plays, and that's what's happening. And they've done a heck of a job so far as first down plays in this ballgame.
Benson. Carrying tacklers near a first down. He'd be short by about a yard, but he still picked up three. Nick Leaders was finally the last man to jump on the pile and ride him down. Well, Mac Brown content to just let some time run off the clock right now. Under 2 minutes to go. The Longhorns looking to extend their lead with the head into halftime. Reminder coming up at halftime. Athletics Director Bruce Vandeveld will be stopping by. Plus, we'll have all the halftime homecoming festivities from here in Homecoming 2003. Well, not much there, but they said he was down. Benson lost the ball. An offensive lineman was able to come away with it for Texas anyway. I think William Winston figured it out, finally came up with it. He or Will Allen, one of the two. But they say he was down. It was Will Allen. Official immediately pointing to the ground.
First down, Texas.
Yeah, that's something Benson does not do very often.
So he got hit. They hit right on that ball. 20 years ago, a running back was easy to play. They just tried to tackle you. Now they try to strip you from every angle. And teams are good at it. And, oh, I tell you, it's hard to do.
Minute 10 to go. Throwing it up top, looking for a man. It's caught by B.J. Johnson.
Yeah, late.
Boy, he played center field looking back into the sun and made that catch.
How about that pass? I'm telling you, that's a well-executed play. He's covered like a blanket, B.J. was, and he makes a great catch on a perfectly thrown pass. People think Vincent Young can't throw the football or nuts because he can throw it. I'll tell you what, he's done a nice job of playing quarterback in this football game.
DeAndre Jackson could not have had any better coverage than he did. And DeAndre Jackson, a young man from Garland, now he knows well of B.J. Johnson. B.J. Johnson is from Grand Prairie, Texas. They're from right down the road from each other.
They probably played in high school against each other.
Absolutely. Well, Johnson's a little bit older, but there are several that B.J. Johnson played against. Ellis Hobbs from DeSoto.
Yeah, yep. And, a lot of Dallas area guys on this team and a lot of Houston area guys on this team.
B.J. Johnson, just his third touchdown catch of the season.
Again, the protection. good passers that are consistently good have good lines, and they've given both quarterbacks a lot of time to throw the football today, and I think that's a credit to the offensive line because, you know, they brought heat, they've blitzed, they've done it all, and they've played every kind of coverage known to man, and I think they're doing a good job of reading the coverages.
Well, Texas has had scoring drives of 242, 215, 227, and this one a 6 minute 29 second scoring drive. Next week, 6 o'clock start as Texas will take on Baylor in Waco, then Nebraska at Oklahoma State. That could be an awfully tough one. It's always tough when you have to play against Texas Tech, and then Texas A&M on November 28th.
I tell you this, the old Baylor gimme victory is no longer in effect either because if you don't believe it, ask Colorado. I know what happened last week at A&M, but Baylor's capable of beating anybody any Saturday. So there's, you know, it's the way it ought to be. There's no buys in this deal. And especially, the toughest schedule in the country, they say, A&M played it. Second toughest in the country, Colorado. Third toughest, Iowa State. And the old Big 12, they'll go play anybody, anytime, anywhere.
Yeah, toughest schedule to date, meaning the teams that you've already faced. Iowa State has the toughest schedule so far as their opponents.
Right.
Their opponents are 23-6 so far this year. They're going to go ahead and bring this one out. David Banks bursting out to the 20-yard line, out to the 21. A 21-yard return.
Of course, the only bad team they've played, Kevin, is Northern Illinois. And, you know, Northern Illinois, they said everybody's going to beat them when the season started. They've beaten about five top 10 teams.
Northern Illinois is outstanding.
I think they're number 14 in the nation right now. And, you know, what a credit to them because that just proves that the rankings don't really mean anything because who would ever thunk that they'd be there?
First and 10, Iowa State.
Well, they backed this one up. Half the distance to the goal, and there's your penalty right there on your screen. Block in the back, pushed him down, whatever you want to call it.
I think at officiating school, they tell these officials on every kick, throw a flag.
Well, there was definitely one there.
I understand. That's what they say on all of them.
No. I don't know about all of them, but whenever it's that clear, and it was clear cut. Well, again, terrible field position here with 1 minute to play for Iowa State. Trying to get away from Kalen Thornton. Balls has a gain of 10 yards, and he's pushed out of bounds there.
Did you see the block Chris Love got the quarterback?
Yeah.
Chris Love, what a block. I'm telling you. Handing the ball off. That's being a watch this block by the quarterback. Watch him the whole way. Number 16. He's going to go out here. He's going to go to the left. Here he comes, and he knocks number 6 down.
Cedric Griffin. He's a pretty good quarterback he took out down there.
I'm telling you.
It's a gain of 11. Stepped out of bounds, stopped the clock with 53 seconds to play.
Love the fighter, I'll say that about him.
And penalty markers down.
I often have wondered how much fun it'd be to play football without a fight.
Prior to the snap, ball start. Offense.
Of course, that's a
5-yard penalty and remains first down.
Yeah.
No, they do a great job. I understand that. But good gosh almighty, they get technical sometimes. You can just play on the honor system, let each team call their own.
Call their own?
Yeah.
Have like a pickup game of basketball?
Mm-hmm. That'd be some of those guys I wouldn't want to play against, though. I got a bunch of friends I wouldn't get in that fight with, I'll tell you that. But it'd be a neat deal.
First down and 15. 15-yard line. Love going up top. And out of bounds. Coverage was great. Now we got 49 seconds to play. Looking for Lance Young, but Cedric Griffin, the man who was blocked by Chris Love just a moment ago, at step-for-step coverage.
I believe I would not throw the ball this play and let that clock run and get out of this half before I had to punt down there from the 15.
Absolutely.
Because nothing good can happen out of that deal. I bet this is a run. I bet you anything it is. And, just need to go on and run the clock up, run the half out, and go around and talk about this.
Not
going to
run it.
They're going
to throw it. And Danielson made the catch, but that was terribly dangerous. A gain of 13 yards. That looks awfully scary.
And guess what? We still got a punt. It's fourth down. They better be careful.
You got third down.
No, no.
Third down or two. Unless we missed a play somewhere, that's not me, but people down on the sideline. Third down and two, and he got out of bounds. So now they're going to have to punt. Instead of falling down and letting the clock run, Love went out of bounds to stop the clock.
See, Kevin, that's what happens, though, when you've been around for a while, but you haven't started. And you haven't done all these situations before, and you know, Chris Love won't do it next time, but that time he should have stayed inbounds and they'd be in the dressing room right now. Now they got to go pull off one of the hardest plays in football to execute, and that's the spread punt.
Nathan Vasher goes back deep.
And he makes it harder because he is a great return guy.
Back it up five more.
But you don't
Prior to the snap,
they all want to get paid.
5 yard penalty, and it remains fourth down.
I'm just kidding. I love some of my best friends are officials, but
I don't believe that for a second.
No, they really are. That is a special breed of cat. Those people are the most dedicated people to that profession I've ever known in my life, and I admire what they do. Couldn't have a game without them. And believe me, they are the salt of the earth.
Yelp gets it away. And so Texas will have the ball with 15 seconds, long enough to take a knee and head for the...
That ball nearly went in that two ball over there.
Missed that one.
First down, Texas. Really, it nearly went right in that two ball on the sideline. Well, they go air it out one play here. Throw it Hail Mary.
Congratulations and
45 yards.
Recipients of 2003 Alumni Association.
Got 15 seconds.
Got enough to get in field goal range. A Chance Mock back in at quarterback now for Texas. Thomas Johnson and Williams all down at the bottom of the screen. Mock being pressured. Has the first down, so they'll stop the clock with 7 seconds left to set the chains. Be looking at a 52-yard field goal right now. Jason Berryman there to escort him to the ground, a gain of 12 yards. They're about a 51-yard field goal.
I tell you, old Dusty Mangum has been good this year now.
I haven't called on him that much. Just two of two, but 28-yard long, but he's definitely got the leg for this.
I see Tony Jeffries out there, the holder. So, he's out in that huddle. So, this is important for Texas right here. This three more points or seven more points really make this game nearly out of reach.
Texas still with a timeout left, so you got 7 seconds.
The only thing you throw is something quick, like an out. Or if they got a timeout left, you can throw a hook. Have somebody at referee's face. I believe with those, this is the kind of deal as a bench jockey coach like me, it's something easy. Saturday afternoon coaches or Sunday afternoon coaches, I believe I would go throw that Hail Mary down there, those 6'5" receivers.
I guess 5'8" quarterbacks.
Yeah.
B.J. Johnson came into this one today, just 9 receptions today. He's got 4 catches, 102 yards.
They're going to throw the out. Looks like a cushion over here about 30 yards. They'll throw it over on the left. Get out of bounds.
Throws it over the middle instead. Johnson slides down at the 15 with 1 second remaining. And immediately called a timeout. You couldn't execute it any better than he did right there. Gain of 20 yards.
great play.
And a timeout with 1 second remaining.
That's a smart job. That's a good job by the Texas coaches, because that's about any longer than that, the half's over. So they knew what they were doing. They used the time to the fullest extent. And I tell you, this is 3 points is very important. 27 points, about different 24 points.
31-yard attempt here from Mangum. DJ Johnson, 5 receptions in the first half. Mangum from 31 yards. Did Iowa State leave too much time on the clock? They sure did.
Yep.
Final play of the first half. First half dominated by the Texas Longhorns. One look at the scoreboard will tell you that. 27-0, Texas on top. They've been impressive in just about every facet of the game. And let's go down onto the field. Chuck Reed.
Workmanlike effort by the Longhorns first half.
Well, it was a great first half for us. Our defense played really well when we had some sudden change and some field position problems and into the wind there early in the first quarter, and gave us a chance to move the ball. And offensive, we've moved the ball and made some big plays. And Dan McCarney's a great coach, and they're an emotional team. They're going to come back out and fight the second half, so we got to come back out and play the same way to finish.
We'll see both Young and Mock at quarterback again second half.
Yes, we'll see both of them the second half. They're both doing a good job.
Yes, they are. Congratulations,
thank you,
Coach. Back up to you, Kevin.
All right, 27-0 at halftime. So far, it's been a good trip to Ames, Iowa for the Texas Longhorns. They are dominating in the first half of play. We'll take a break. We've got more to come from Ames, Iowa in just a moment. Much, Chuck.